We start with the developing story out of St. Paul. This morning, a church off of West 7th was heavily damaged by fire. Five Eyewitness News reporter Jennifer Ann Wilson is on scene now. Jennifer, anybody hurt here?
Nobody was hurt. There were no injuries, and that's really the good news here. And more good news is that the fire was put out quickly, but still, there was some damage, significant damage. And this is a church you see here behind me that's been here for more than 50 years. A lot of people in the community came up to me, and whether they attended the church or not, they were very concerned, offering their help. And the pastor himself, he's been the pastor here for over 30 years. I spoke with him off camera. He had tears in his eyes, and this is just a very difficult moment for him, especially since he was scheduled to perform a funeral here at 10:30 this morning, but he hasn't been able to do that. You can see there's actually people standing on the front steps. They are redirecting people. Another church nearby has offered to hold the funeral services for them, but in the meantime, firefighters are still trying to figure out how this all began. They got the call around 7:30 this morning.
A passerby driving or walking by saw smoke billowing out from the eaves of the church. That was what the report was. But when firefighters got here just a couple minutes later, the fire started coming out the windows up to the roof, flapping the outside of the building. When firefighters entered and knocked it down right away.
In less than 15 minutes, they got the flame out, but the damage was already done. St. Paul's fire marshal says the fire was confined to the second floor of the church's addition that contains offices and classrooms. The fire did not touch the sanctuary, but there is potential smoke damage that they are still assessing, and the cause of the fire is still under investigation. But one neighbor tells me he doesn't believe the fire was an accident.
I wanted to talk to the fire investigator just because I think I know who started it. I hope, frankly, that they can get the person out of the neighborhood, because he's known for setting fires in other parts of the neighborhood too, and he just happened to be walking towards the church right before it happened.
At this point, we do still have investigators on scene. We also have crews on scene assessing the damage and trying to get things cleaned up as quickly as possible. And again, we've got people on the front porch here who are trying to redirect people who were coming to a funeral for a woman who attended this church for more than 50 years, practically since the building was built. So this is definitely a pretty big deal. And of course, we are just a couple of weeks away from Christmas. And coming up in the next half an hour, we're going to talk to the family members of the woman whose funeral was supposed to be held here. And I'll tell you a little bit more about how they are coping with all of this morning. Reporting live in St. Paul, Jennifer Ann Wilson, 5 Eyewitness News.
Today, the this morning, a church off of West 7th in St. Paul was damaged by fire. 5 Eyewitness News reporter Jennifer Ann Wilson spoke to some of the people who've been around this church since it opened its doors.
For over 50 years, St. Mark's Lutheran Church has been a part of Emmett Burdash's life.
I played in the bricks as they were building it. And today was supposed to be my sister's funeral here.
Today, services for his sister Donna were scheduled for 10:30. Plans were forced to change.
Well, this morning when I was taking the garbage out, I smelled smoke.
The call came in at 7:30 a.m.
When firefighters arrived, there was heavy smoke on the second floor.
Flames shot through the roof and broke through the glass.
And the fire was starting to come out of the office area on part of the church.
The fire was out in less than 15 minutes.
We don't have a cause yet, but fortunately, it did spread to the church itself, the worship area.
The church is a real neighborhood institution, and the minister's very involved and knows everybody, and it's a place the kids go for summer Bible school.
It's also where Emmett raised his children and where he and his sisters grew up.
This is the middle sister. It's away from Alzheimer's.
That was Jennifer Ann Wilson reporting this midday. This morning, three.